button you understand thoroughly. There is little mathematics involved in process approach. Process approach is otherwise called as y equal to f of x. Imagine you are growing an orange tree. So what kind of fruits you will get from the tree? You will get oranges. But I want to produce apple. Tell me, will I be able to produce apple from the same tree? No. If I want apple, then I have to grow an apple tree. Similarly, when I have a process, when I run the same process, my result will be same. Am I correct? When I run the same process, my result will be same. When I want better result, I must improve the process. So process improvement is an unavoidable event in any company, because every company wants to improve the result. But improving the result requires an improvement or a change in the process. Change is something, you know, will never change. Isn't it? So improvement, process improvement is the key to success. No? This is what is called, you know, process-centric approach. So if you want to change the fruits, it's very important you change the roots. And this is what we call it, process-centric approach, y equal to f of x. And now, in the context of problem solving, why is the problem you need to solve? What is why? Why is the problem? You know what is the problem? The defect rate is 12%. That is the problem. You know what is the problem? The compressive strength of the concrete block you manufacture is not according to the customer requirement. That is the problem. So what is why? Why is defect rate? So what is why? Why is compressive strength of the material? Compressive strength of the material is not at the required level. Why compressive strength is not at the required level? Because the mixture used is not correct. What do you use as a mixture to produce a concrete block? Can you list out? What do you use? How do you produce a concrete block? Come on. This is a question to you.
Cement, gravel,
sand, and water.
Very good. Cement, sand, water, some steel ingredients. You put everything and then you get a concrete block. And now the compressive strength of the concrete block is Y or X? Which is Y here? The compressive strength of the concrete block, is it an Y or X?
It's a Y.
It's a Y variable. We call it Y variable because the compressive strength of the concrete block depends on the mixture, you know, proportion. How much sand you put, how much cement you put, how much, you know, like water you add, and this decides the compressive strength. Since compressive strength depends on sand, cement, and water, compressive strength is a Y variable. Y variables are mathematically called as dependent variable. Am I correct? Now tell me, will you be able to control a dependent variable? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now I change the question. You have to be very, very, very careful. Will you be able to directly control the Y variable?
No, sir.
No, sir.
You can't. You can't, you know, change the compressive strength without changing the cement, water, and, you know, sand. Am I correct? So without touching X, you can't touch the Y. So Y is the pain metric. Pain metric is always a dependent variable. When you are doing a project, you must thoroughly understand about your Y variable. Y should be a dependent variable. Please understand. If Y variable is not a dependent variable, if you don't understand what is your Y variable, take it granted, you are not going to solve. Am I correct? Yes or no? All of this, Y variable should be correctly identified. And then the X variables are called the factors. X, Y variable is called what? The problem. X variables are called as what? The factors. Mathematically, X variables are called independent variable. You know why I call it independent variable? I can fix it instantly. I want to increase the water. Will I be able to increase? I can increase, isn't it? But it, because I can directly control, what I can control directly is called independent variable. What I cannot control directly, rather I can control indirectly, those are called dependent variable. All of you understand the difference between dependent variable and independent variable? I need a big yes now.
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Now, yes. So this is called problem solving. This is called a process approach. And now, if I want to solve a problem, I think let me take 1 minute. Okay. So let me take a simple example, because